When you think about the Olympics, one of the first things you probably think about is the Olympic flag with its five colored rings. These rings represent the five parts of the world that were united through the Olympic movement. But you probably didn't know that the Olympics started as a much smaller competition founded by the ancient Greeks in the year 776 BC, over 2,700 years ago. As opposed to this cluster of flags from all around the world, in ancient times there were many fewer people eligible to compete in the Olympics back in ancient Greece. In ancient times, athletes had to be free as well as to be able to speak Greek in order to compete. Most contestants came from different regions of Greece, but some athletes came from places as far as France and Egypt. Whereas currently the Olympics move cities every 4 years and athletes play their sports in shiny new facilities, in ancient times the Olympics stayed in one city and competed in arenas made of wood and stone. While the torch lighting ceremony did start in the ancient Olympics, it wasn't until the modern Olympics that the torch run began. Past Olympic athletes run around the world carrying the Olympic flame to symbolize that the Olympics bring people together from all across the world. While in ancient Greece, winners of Olympic events received olive wreaths to wear as crowns to show their accomplishment, in the modern Olympics, our winners receive either a gold, silver, or bronze medal to show their athletic achievements. No matter what sport, or whether they were competing in ancient or modern-day Olympic events, winning athletes are praised by their home communities for their strength and courage, and are viewed as heroes for the next 4 years until the next Olympics.